Hi, I'm Jeremy Bender, and this is my show.
Our show.
Our show. That's Martin Gardens. You can't see him because he's holding the camera. Give me the camera for a second. Hello. Okay, that's enough. Martin and I decided to make a TV show about the dorm we live in. It's called Sullivan Hall. The dorm, not the TV show. The TV show is called Dormented. We go to Stonehill College. You've probably never heard of it unless you go here. We wanted to make a TV show about the people who live in our dorm because we decided that they're strange enough to be on TV. Except us. We're not strange. Well, I used to be in therapy, but that doesn't mean I'm strange. I'm not in therapy anymore, though. My psychiatrist refused to see me again. I can't actually remember what I said to him, but I do remember that his secretary had to forcibly restrain him from pulling the fire alarm. This is my room. I live in the basement, Sullivan B4. Martin lives in B6. I live with my roommate, Penn Jarvis.
He's not gonna be back tonight, is he?
No, he's at church. Martin's scared of Penn Jarvis. I think I am too, I'm not sure. Penn Jarvis likes to have sex with people. At least, I think he restricts himself to people. I came home one day and he had rearranged the furniture so that the beds were together like this. He said it was easier to have sex that way. I don't think he meant with me, but I'm not sure. Did I mention that Stonehill is a Catholic school?
No.
Stonehill is a Catholic school. Penn Jarvis is bisexual. I think I might be too, but I worry that subconsciously I just want to be politically correct. I am quite sure that I would very much like to make love to Mindy Cohn. I'm not sure why this is so, but I strongly suspect it has to do with the reasons why my psychiatrist won't talk to me anymore. She played Natalie on The Facts of Life.
Tell us about yourself.
Jeremy says that before we talk to the other people who live in this dorm, we have to talk about ourselves.
Your public wants to meet you. Talk about yourself.
My name is Martin Gardens. When I was younger, kids used to make fun of me because of the Monopoly space, Marvin Gardens. Actually, they still do. What else?
I think that about sums it up.
Sullivan Hall is divided into 5 suites. Each suite has 5 rooms for 2 people each, a bathroom, and a common room. There are 5 suites in the building, 2 all men and 3 all women. Martin and I don't usually hang out with the guys in our suite, neither does Penn Jarvis. They like to destroy things. Let's go see if any of them are here. Bull.
What are you doing?
We're making a TV show. Bull, what do you like to do in your free time?
Girls, drink beer, and break things.
And what's your major?
College studies.
Hey, no, not the camera, not the camera!
We're on the second floor. This is my friend Hepzibah's room. She's very interesting. Martin's afraid of her. Let's see if she's in. Hi, Hepzibah. We're making a TV show.
How delicious of you. Come and give me a kiss or I shall strike you. Don't worry about it, Martin. I'll remember that you're in my debit. Item, 1 kiss.
Right.
What are you doing, Hepzibah?
My homework.
Hepzibah's an accounting major. Isn't that a Ouija board?
The spirits are helping me. Right now, I'm in communion with a CPA who passed away last year.
How did he die?
Place your fingers upon the planchette and ask your question.
Okay. How did you die? B O R E D O M.
Hey guys, what's going on?
Hi Blair. This is Blair, Hepzibah's roommate. We're making a TV show. Want to be interviewed?
No, I'm really busy. Burn in hell! Burn in hell! Worship Satan! Red room! Red room!
Blair's possessed by Satan. She's a communications major. Hepzibah, why don't you tell everyone how Blair came to be possessed?
My name is Legion! Don't recycle! Use aerosol sprays!
I had a calculus test last month and I thought that Satan would be of some help, so I summoned him. And Blair walked in at an inopportune moment.
Bad luck for her.
Everything balances. I got an A.
Kiss the devil! The square of the length of the hypotenuse of a right triangle is equal to the sum of the squares of the lengths of the other two sides. Worship Satan. Burn in hell.
This is Flower. She's a vegetarian.
Actually, I don't eat meat or vegetables. They're all living beings. It's wrong to kill to feed ourselves.
So what do you eat?
Mostly water. And vitamins.
What are you doing now?
I'm meditating. It brings my center of being into harmony with Gaia.
Who's Gaia?
Gaia is the All-Mother. She is nature, the spirit of the earth.
Is she a friend of yours?
She is a friend to all who live. Come, Jeremy. Come, Martin. Meditate with me.
Okay. What do I do now?
Pontificate.
I don't think we can do that on television.
Ponder. Open your mind. Consider the universe and your place in it.
Okay.
Close your eyes.
I think she's asleep.
We're in the guy's suite on the second floor. Two of my friends live here. Their names are Hack and Payne. Martin's afraid of them. You ready?
I guess so.
Hello?
Get it! Move it! Go, 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 go!
This is Hack. What are you doing?
Keeping my weapon properly maintained.
Hack likes weapons.
They're out there, you know. And they're coming. And the robot's not gonna stop them. Oh, no. And keeping your door locked's not gonna stop them. Only this is gonna stop them. Cold, hard, steel.
Who's they?
What?
Who's they, Hack?
Them!
Oh, okay. This is Payne. Hi, Payne. What's new?
Life is a meaningless void.
No, what's new?
Death, sleep, end.
Pain is very deep.
He's crazy. They're all crazy but me. But I won't let them get us. Don't worry. I'll protect us.
Great. Thanks, Hack. So tell us about yourself, Pain.
Why?
Because Martin and I are making a TV show. It's called Dormented.
Yes. Yes, I see.
How perfect!
Mother?
This is Enya, like the singer, except she can't sing and her hair's different. We're doing a TV show, Enya. Is it all right if we interview you? Okay, great, thanks. Tell us a little about yourself. Do people often confuse you for the singer Enya, Enya? What's it like having a letter of the Spanish alphabet for a name? Those are nice shoes. Enya lives right next door to Hepzibah. Do you like roller coasters? I guess she's a little nervous in front of the camera.
Look at all the colors.
Martin's been telling me about trick photography. He's going to make me disappear. Did it work?
Hi. This is my roommate, Pen Jarvis. Remember I told you about him at the start of the show?
Hello.
Tell us something about yourself, Pen Jarvis.
I am a creature of the flesh.
Really? That's very interesting. Do you like hiking?
I need release, Jeremy.
Oh. I told you, Pen Jarvis, I can't get over this Mindy Cohen thing.
Mindy Cohen, what does she have that I don't?
Residuals?
Ha. Residuals won't keep you warm at night.
What are residuals?
Money given to actors in a TV show every time an episode appears in syndication. Since you spurn me once again, Jeremy, I will seek release elsewhere. Martin?
Okay, that's enough.
I'm not special. Pen Jarvis comes on to everybody. The guys in my suite all hate him because he keeps stealing their girlfriends. And when they go to beat him up, he asks them if they'd like him.
What's going on out here?
Hi. This is Connie.
What are you two doing? Is that video camera?
Yes.
My God, I'm not dressed!
She's actually very nice once you get to know her. Her roommate's name is Bitsy. But don't hold that against her. Maybe she's finished dressing now.
Tell him it's not on.
What?
Tell him the camera's not on.
I don't want to lie to them.
Why not?
Oh, okay. Connie? Bitsy? Come on out. The camera's not on. We're just pretending.
Practicing.
Practicing.
Promise?
No.
Yes, he means yes.
What's that red light mean?
It means we're taping.
No, it means low battery level. Come on out. Come on.
I guess we can talk to them later. This is Eloise's room. She's a really good friend of mine. She's very dedicated. I guess she's not home.
Hi, Jeremy. Hi, Martin.
Hi, Beth. This is Beth.
What you doing?
We're making a TV show.
Yes, I heard. Interviewing everybody except me. I suppose you're gonna try and slip it by me unnoticed.
Well,
that was sort of the idea, yeah.
Oh, that's all right. It's nothing new. So how have you been, Jeremy?
I have two cavities. And you?
Well, the other night, while I was cutting up pictures of you, I'd swallowed an entire bottle of sleeping pills. Unfortunately, my roommate came home and called an ambulance. They pulled my stomach, so I'm all right now.
That's good. How is your roommate? Emily?
Sandy!
Right.
What do you care? What do you care about anything in my life, you heartless? Oh!
That was Beth. I sort of broke up with her once. Hi, this is Eloise, my dedicated friend. She came in just as we were getting ready to leave. What's new, Eloise?
What should I say?
Whatever. This is for local access.
Oh. Vote Clinton Gore 92. Turn the bums out. Bush is a fascist.
Eloise?
What?
The election's over.
Oh. Vote Clinton Gore 96. 96! 4 more years! 4 more!
choose.
Choose what?
Everything. God, if I didn't have the right to make decisions, I'd never be able to get dressed in the morning.
She also supports gay rights.
The homosexuals are wonderful people. I don't actually think that we have any here at Stonehill. But if we did, I would support their right to do, well, you know, with each other.
Sometimes the strength of your convictions frightens me.
Hi, my name's Beth Medina. You probably saw me earlier if those two didn't edit me out, which, well, it really wouldn't surprise me in the least. Anyway, I borrowed Martin's camera because I wanted to set the record straight. Jeremy did not dump me, and I am not bitter about it. We both saw the end coming. He may have seen it a little bit before I did. All right, maybe I was a little bit possessive, but is that a crime? I mean, we were in love. And when you're in love, is it so wrong to want to know exactly what they're doing and why and for how long and with who and when they'll be back and if they miss you? I mean, I just don't understand why Jeremy kept shutting me out. God, I feel a migraine coming on.
Beth, I know you have my camera and I want it back. Beth, I know you're in there.
Gotta go. Beth. Bye.
I was gone for 1 second and she takes off with my camera.
Shh. I don't know how long Bitsy can take this. Hi. I finally persuaded Bitsy to talk to us. Hi, Bitsy. Say something.
What should I say?
Tell us about yourself. How do you like living with Connie?
She's okay.
Do you like living in Sullivan?
It's okay.
What do you like about it? What's your major?
Communications.
What do you think about it?
It's okay.
I'm ready now.
Bitsy, you're wearing that outfit on television?
Oh. Oh.
Bye, Bitsy.
My name's Connie. Connie Island? No, I'm just kidding. My real name is Constance Harcourt, but all my friends call me Connie. I'm 20 years old. I'm a junior. I'm from Connecticut. I'm studying business administration with a minor in computer information systems. And I enjoy looking my best, attending formal events with a handsome man, hand modeling, and full contact tackle football in the rain.
That's very interesting.
I like to hurt people.
I know.
I can feel the air in my lungs.
Really? What does it feel like?
Hi, Jeremy.
Hi, Anya.
Hi, Hack.
That wasn't very nice.
Shut up!
Eloise is showing me pictures.
This is my kitty cat, Mondo. Isn't she cute? I'm holding her real close to my face, even though her fur tickled.
Nice.
She's dead now.
Is she dead in this picture?
Yes.
Hepzibah's having a seance. She said we could tape it if we were quiet.
Do we have to have the camera on?
Quiet, lover. Place your fingers on the planchette, those who are participating. If anyone pushes, I shall strike you.
I'll kill you if you strike me.
Of course, lover. Spirits arise. Speak to us, spirit. We wish to speak to you.
Burn in hell!
If I had wanted to speak to Satan, I would have asked for Satan. Control your demonic possession, Blair, or I shall strike you. Is there a spirit present?
Oh, it's moving. How spiritual.
This is scary.
It says yes.
What is your name, spirit?
R-U-D... Why, Rudy?
How did you die?
I bet he died in a knife fight.
I hope he died in bed.
I wouldn't be the least bit surprised if he killed himself.
Probably died in great pain.
Maybe he's not dead. Maybe he's the spirit of the earth.
Maybe you should all be quiet and let him answer. He spelled out old age. How dreary. Tell us, spirit, will anything interesting happen here tonight?
It's moving again. H. A. C. K. Hack.
What? What does it want with me?
W. I. L. L. Hack will. K. I. L. L. Hack will kill.
Oh boy.
F. L. O. W. E. R. Flower. Hack will kill flower. Hey, that's me.
I sense that the spirit has departed.
Hey, flower.
Stay away!
Great seance, Hepzibah. That was really cool.
I'm glad that you are impressed by me. Now I must do work.
I wasn't planning to kill flower.
Maybe she's going to irritate you later.
Yeah, maybe.
And you look... Hello, Martin. Is that on?
Nope.
All right. Anya, you look ravishing this evening.
Thank you.
Your eyes, your hair, everything about you is radiant.
Thank you.
I do believe that I have never seen a more beautiful creature than yourself at this very moment.
Thank you.
If I'm not being too bold, may I ask what you think about me?
Your face is melting.
Is it on? Hello, lovers. Martin has agreed to let me put a little message on his show. Are you recently dead and don't know where to turn? Is the afterlife you expected merely a confusing fog? In your previous life, did you know anything about accounting, statistics, or mathematics? Then come to me, Hepzibah Hellstrom. Feel my psychic energies and follow them to my demismes. Answer a few simple questions about your work and life, and then, provided I get a B+ or better, I will assist you in following the path to the divine light of your choice. It's a simple choice. Help me with my homework, or be doomed to walk forever in misery for eternity in hell. Think about it. Farewell, lovers. Thank you, Martin. Martin, are you all right?
When I was little, I wanted to go to the Electoral College. I came to Stonehill.
Jeremy, Brian, enemy incoming! I couldn't stop her! She was just too powerful for me!
Beth?
Worse!
Oh no, Megan?
Too late!
Jeremy, oh my god! Give me a hug before I spew!
Hi, Megan.
I missed you so much. I heard about your little television show and I ran right over because what's a television show without me? Nothing, right? I said to myself, Megan, get yourself over to Sullivan because Jeremy needs you. God, this place has not changed a bit. I swear to God.
This is Megan Harvey. She lived here last year, but now she lives in a townhouse.
I missed you so much. Tell me how much you missed me.
I've thought about you.
Jeremy, control yourself.
Okay.
Our love was never meant to be.
Our love?
Look, please, I can't bear to hear it again.
I don't...
I know you don't think there's a problem. Maybe if you believe in our love, that's enough. I'm willing to give it a second try if you are.
Second try?
Jeremy, you sweep me off my feet. Hey, Martin, we're reconciling here. You mind? Beat it or I'll slice your face open. Jeremy...
Oh, it's you.
Hello, Beth.
Hello, Megan.
Jeremy and I were just going out. On a date.
What? Oh, how lucky for you, dating such a giant step up on the evolutionary chain.
Huh? She making fun of me?
I don't think it's fun. We're not dating.
I don't care. I think it's fairly egotistical of you to think I care, Jeremy. God.
I don't think I like your attitude, princess.
Well, I don't think I like your...
Jews! All right, that's enough out of you! I'll be back for you, pretty boy.
Most people are scared of men. This is the only way Bitsy can talk on camera.
Hi.
Can you breathe?
Sometimes.
So, tell us about your relationship with Connie.
She's okay.
Do you get along with her?
Sometimes.
What about the other times?
Sometimes she's very dynamic.
Yes. Does that bother you?
No, not at all. Well, maybe. A little. Sometimes.
Bitsy, what are you doing under there? Get out before you suffocate. She's such an adorable little mouse, isn't she? Watch this. Bitsy, your mother called. She's coming to visit for a whole month. I get along great with Bitsy's mother. The three of us go out and talk about Bitsy.
About Bitsy?
Well, sure, I mean, that's the only thing the three of us have in common. We think of ways that Bitsy can improve herself. For God's sake, Bitsy, would you clean up after yourself? God, this place is such a sty. What do you do all day besides lie in bed making those irritating squeaking noises? God, you're totally useless. What would you do without me? Is she crying?
I think so.
Right.
Connie, what's your definition of evil?
What? Oh, Hitler was evil, right?
Ow!
I'm sorry. Are you bleeding?
You struck me with a pin.
I said I was sorry.
I'm going to go see if Bitsy's all right.
Why? Hi, Martin. Oh, this is my pen.
Why don't you tell Connie to stop being so mean to you?
She frightens me.
Connie frightens us all.
But if you don't stand up to her, she'll never stop.
Oh, no, I couldn't do that.
Why not?
Because she'd hit me with something.
Connie has a very dark aura. It's disturbing the whole building. I'll talk to her. I think I can help her.
Are you going to talk to her now?
No, later. First, I must prepare myself. I must purge myself of all impurities. I have a feeling that this confrontation with Connie will be a major catharsis for both of us. Perhaps one that will reshape our very identities, an intensely personal experience.
Can we tape it?
Sure.
Hi. While Flower's purging herself, I think I'd better straighten something out. Martin just told me that we don't really have a plot. It's hard to work out a plot in advance when you're just taping things as they happen. Nostradamus would have made a good candid filmmaker. I guess there's been two interesting things so far. The Ouija board saying Hack was going to kill Flower, and Flower's going to talk to Connie about Bitsy. So if you're wondering what the show is about, I guess we'll try and focus on those two things.
I'm going to set myself on fire.
Won't that hurt?
Pain. I feel your sorrow.
Yes, yes.
Life is a meaningless void.
I know.
God is dead. The world is bleak. There is no meaning.
You do understand.
Faced with such a cold and uncaring world, there's only one thing to do.
Yes.
Sleep with me.
No. I'm going to write intense poetry in the dark while listening to progressive music.
I thought you had him.
This is the front hallway of Sullivan Hall. We called the show Dormented, even though Sullivan isn't called a dorm. We wanted to be accessible to our audience. I died of syphilis in a previous life, but I didn't give it to anyone.
Hi, guys. Still making your show?
Hi, Blair. Yes, we are. Where are you coming from?
I just had a meeting with a professor about a paper.
What was the paper on?
The importance of ritual human sacrifice in the modern world. He gave me an F.
Well, that's too bad.
Well, I was supposed to write on some 19th century author, but this other topic interested me much more, and so I went to argue with him about it.
Did he change his mind?
Well, not at first, but when his desk burst into flames and the ceiling started to bleed and tortured faces pushed out from the walls, he gave me an A.
That's great. Congratulations.
Thanks. See you later.
I said she's possessed by Satan, right?
I wonder if it's difficult to clean blood off the ceiling.
It is.
Just popped in to say hi. Isn't this neat? Look, I'll turn into Pen Jarvis.
Can I get up now?
No, don't move.
Make him disappear. Now I'll turn into different things.
Hi, Jeremy. You told me to come and get you when I was ready to talk to Connie.
Thanks, Flower. We'll be right up.
All right.
What's up, Flower?
Connie, sit with me. You too, Jeremy. Bitsy? You can just stay there. Connie, we're all very concerned about you.
Why?
You know that we all love you very much.
Yeah, sure, whatever.
And we all know that you're a good person.
And you dress very well.
Thank you, Jeremy.
Ow, please don't do that. I bruise easily.
You should really eat more. In fact, you should eat, period.
The plants survive off the earth. I can do the same.
Well,
Connie,
you better teach yourself to photosynthesize then.
Connie, I feel that we're straying from the subject.
Can you really teach yourself to photosynthesize?
It was a joke, Jeremy. Learn to deal with reality.
That hurts, Connie.
Jeremy, please. Connie, we're all mainly concerned about the way you treat Bitsy.
If she has a problem, then why doesn't she tell me?
Bitsy feels slightly intimidated by you.
Why? Tell me what it is I do. I don't think I understand.
You have a tendency to hurt.
Sometimes Flower faints from lack of food.
Let's put dust in her mouth.
Hi. Martin said I could take this opportunity to address all the people who are watching. Look, I know there's a lot of injustice in the world. There's pain and sorrow and murder and people hurting other people. Governments are falling apart and other countries are on the brink of war. Governments are oppressing their people in all kinds of really awful ways. To all those people who are hurting their fellow man, I just want to say, we'll quit it, okay? I mean, geez.
Great, Eloise. Really impassioned.
You think? How did I sound? Did I sound tough?
I was scared of you.
Well, you're scared of everyone.
Hi, Bull. What are you doing?
Thinking about water.
Great. Keep it up.
I had a dream about you, baby. They think that we're through.
Sometimes Pen Jarvis likes to pretend he's Ethel Merman. I think we all can relate to that. That's not a very good impersonation, though, because Ethel Merman is dead.
Jeremy, Megan and I have been talking.
Does anyone else think this is going to be very bad for me?
There he goes, thinking about himself. You have to choose.
Choose?
Between Beth and me. Beth says you're still carrying a torch for her, but you said you wanted to date me. So make up your mind.
Yes, Jeremy, just for once and for all. Just be a man and make a decision.
Don't leave us hanging, Jeremy.
We're waiting.
Beth or Megan? It ain't that hard.
Who's it gonna be?
Pen Jarvis, want to get something to eat?
Sure.
See you later.
Hi. I'm Bolt. Do you girls like water?
Hi. The ladies upstairs are having sort of a party. I guess that's the end of the show. I hope you liked it. I'm sorry about that no plot thing. Flower took some vitamins and she's feeling much better. Oh, there was sort of an ending to that part about Hat killing Flower, but it was sort of stupid, so we edited it out. See, Hepzibah had this flower in a pot, and Hack knocked it off the table and stepped on it, so that killed the flower. Sorry if you were expecting something a little more exciting. Martin, why don't you go and wander through the suite, and I'll wait here until you get back.
Okay.
Say goodbye, Martin.
Bye.
Bye.
Cottonwood trees, send me off forever, but I ask you please.
Don't fence me in. Don't fence me in.
Just turn me loose, let me straddle my old saddle underneath the western skies. On my cayuse, let me wander over yonder till I see the mountains rise. I want to ride to the ridge where the west commences, gaze at the moon until I lose. I can't look at hobbles and I can't stand fences.
Don't fence me in. Don't fence me in.
That I love.
Don't fence me in.
Let me be by myself in the evening breeze. Listen to the murmur of the cottonwood trees. Send me off forever, but I ask you please.
Don't fence me in. Don't fence me in.
Just turn me loose. Let me straddle my old saddle underneath the western skies. On my kayuse, let me wander over yonder till I see the mountains.